Yeah, so hi, Microbehunter here again. Look what I found here. These are spirochetes, and I'm not talking about those big cells that you see swimming around here, but those tiny, thin, thread-like, spiral-shaped structures. These are bacteria that I found in a water sample. The density of these spirochetes is quite high. How is this possible? Well, I added a little bit of food to the water sample that I collected from a local pond. And after a few days, I did not only find a whole bunch of Paramecia and those other ciliates swimming around. There are also small, tiny ones there as well, but also a whole bunch of these spiral-shaped bacteria. Now, when I saw those, of course, I was quite happy. Wow, great, some interesting bacteria. And those spirochetes are indeed quite large. Large, therefore can be easily seen. I have to tell you, I have to be a little bit careful here, because some spirochetes actually are known to cause diseases. So for example, borreliosis, the so-called Lyme disease, is caused by spirochetes and some other diseases as well. Now, this does not mean that those bacteria specifically are dangerous. After all, they were not cultured from a human being, but they're basically in a pond. However, generally, when one is enriching or growing bacteria, one has to be careful, because ultimately, you do not know what you're growing, right? And so for this reason, after I put the sample on the microscope, I essentially had to properly disinfect it and clean everything away, because I do not want to have those bacteria essentially being spread around on my desk and on my fingers and whatnot. Now, those ciliates that you see there, they of course feed on organisms that are significantly smaller than they are, often also bacteria. But if you just have a little size comparison here, you can see that those spirochetes, what a tongue twister, that they're almost the same length as those ciliates that you see here. So I have my doubts whether they're actually able to engulf them and eat them up. I don't know. Nature is diverse, and it can be quite well possible that they're finding plenty of other food sources as well. Now, you might have noticed that those bacteria and also those ciliates, they like to gather around in a strip right through the center of the field of view. And this actually is quite common when there is a concentration gradient of oxygen. Essentially, what they do is those bacteria will sometimes actually move along the slide towards an area of higher oxygen concentration. And I can imagine that this is also the case here. I simply did not follow them sufficiently long to actually see them move along. But this is indeed something that I've already observed in the past, that they actually move towards the edge of the cover glass, because this is where the oxygen concentration is indeed the highest. Well, in any case, I was happy that I was able to find those little critters here. It reminds me again, you have to be a little bit patient, and you have to have a little bit of luck when you're putting things under the microscope, because occasionally you can find a few interesting things here as well. I just wanted to share this with you. I hope that you liked the video. I wish you all the best and happy microbe hunting as always. And of course, see you around next time. Bye-bye.